E gridate, 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 sai a me che me ne importa. E parlate, parlate, io fingerò di ascoltarvi per l'ennesima volta.
Parliamo di austerity. È possibile ridurre allo stesso tempo tasse e deficit? Quali sarebbero le conseguenze di queste riduzioni? E ci sono altre opzioni?
Let's talk about austerity. Is it possible to reduce public deficit and taxes simultaneously? What will be the consequences of these reductions? Do we have some other options?
Right, so if you line up 1,000 economists, economic forecasters, every one of them will agree that if you cut spending, the economy will get worse. GDP will go down, unemployment will go up. Every one of them will agree that if you raise taxes, unemployment will go up, the economy will get worse. Every single one agreed. There's no disagreement. Okay, so why would anybody want to do that if everyone knows it makes the economy worse? And Europe has proven it now. Has proven the obvious, that if you take money away from people, the economy is worse. So why would they want to do it? Because they see some other benefit to reducing the deficit. And what I'm saying is there is no particular benefit or not benefit of the deficit being larger or smaller when you're, you know, for the issuer of the currency. Now, Italy and the other members have put themselves in a position like U.S. states where they need to rely on the European Central Bank to do all the financing. And finally, that's happened. And now, right now, for all practical purposes, the central bank, the ECB, is guaranteeing the debt. So solvency, going broke, not being able to fund yourself, is not a problem as long as the central bank is there. And that's true with every country in the world. That's just how currencies work. Once you've recognized the solvency problem is not there, then what difference does it make if the deficit's larger or smaller? Okay, it doesn't make any difference. What makes a difference is whether unemployment is high or low. What makes a difference is what your real terms of trade are. Are you getting the most for your exports? You know, and what is distribution of your income? And your wealth, is your institutional structure causing certain people to get all the income and other people to get nothing? It's all institutional structure that does that. It's not some natural order of things that creates, bond traders. This is something created by government, you know, that doesn't actually need to be there. And lawyers and tax accountants and all these things are created by our legal structure that sets up taxes so complicated that we, you know, empower lawyers to make millions of dollars a year trying to figure it out. We don't have to have this. Okay, but to get back to your question on austerity, it's driven by this myth that the deficit itself has something wrong with it. And that was reinforced by the structure of the European Union, where it was set up to turn Italy, France, Greece, Germany into what are like U.S. states. And just like the U.S. states, just like California can go broke, or Connecticut, Greece or Portugal or even Germany can go broke if things go wrong. However, the European Central Bank doesn't run out of euro any more than the Fed runs out of dollars. It wasn't too long ago, the European Central Bank just spent 1 trillion euro. Did anybody ask if that was someone's tax money? Did anybody ask if they borrowed it from China? No. They just credit numbers on the account. There's no question the European Central Bank can spend without being constrained by any kind of revenues. The only thing that constrains it is the political will. If the finance ministers say you can't write a check for this bank, then they can't write it. If the finance ministers say you can write the check, then that check will clear and the funds will go through. Same thing with the Federal Reserve. Chairman Bernanke was asked where the bailout money came from for the banks, and he said, we just mark up the numbers in their accounts. It's not taxpayer money. It doesn't come from anywhere. And that's exactly right. All central banks spend their own currency simply by making data entries into their computer. Okay, and the question to do it or not do it is political. There's no market involved. There's no discipline from interest rates or anything like that. And if you notice, all the central banks set their own interest rates. They have a meeting and they take a vote and the rate is zero, or the rate is one, the rate is two. There's no market driving that rate. Okay, and so they're completely in control. The currency itself is a very simple public monopoly. And the central bank is the monopolist. It controls the monopoly. And a monopolist is always price setter and not price taker. And a monopolist always determines value for his own product. by telling you what you have to do to get it. He's the only one with it. Okay, and so, you know, this austerity, I just call it a crime against humanity at this point. It's awful. And it's all done on either a misconception or, you know, some horrendous plan that I can't even imagine anybody would actually have. From all the people I've talked to, I think it's a misconception, but I could be wrong. It could be some grand conspiracy. I just, you know, I'm too little a person to know. I'm not in those circles.
Non sapete ascoltare.